Hello friends, today we begin with file handling in C programming. So file management in C, it includes defining and opening a file, closing a file, input-output operations on files, error handling during input-output files, random access to files, and some other functions and operations that I would be showing you. In case of opening an inventory database and stuff like that. So moving on ahead, you may wonder why we need files. Why are they needed? In the unit so far that we have covered, that is unit 2, unit 3, we have seen that whenever we needed to process any data, we gave the input on a console. So when I say console, I'm referring to the black screen where you put in all your values. Alright. Over there, you gave input as values. For example, name of student, age, marks stored, etc. But what happens to these values? Alright. After the program has finished processing it, are these values retained or do we lose these values? Definitely, these values are processed by the C program. And then we lose these values once the C program is terminated. So, what to do to retain these values? Because if we are dealing with a lot of information, just imagine if we are dealing with storing the IT marks of the students in your class for IT1 and IT2 and then computing the average. Maybe you will give 80 students input. But what if I am dealing with computing the average of all the different FEs, the different branches? Will it be appropriate for me to enter the marks every point of time and then to compute the average every time I'm running the program? No. So it's better if I store these values once and for all in a file, and then whenever I need to do any computation on it, probably I'll open the file and do the computation. So that means I am not losing the values once the program is terminated. They are stored there somewhere on my computer system. So C came up with the concept of file handling, where the data given as input for processing was not lost, but stored in the file even if the program was terminated. So that is exactly the reason why we are studying files. The different types of files we would be studying are text files and binary files, but my major focus will be only on text files. Binary files is converting the main file, that is your text file, in zeros and ones. So my major focus will only be on text files. To do this file handling, C gives us different file operations. Or the different file operations that you could do are an analogy to the file operations which you are still doing. Maybe to create a Word file, what do? You go to the software and you say file, new, open file. And if there was already an existing file, you would go to the location and you would just open it, provided the file is existing. And once you finish all the operations on a file, whatever you want to do, you definitely close the file. So that's exactly what file handling in C is also doing. It's helping you create a new file, open an existing file, read from the file and write information to a file, and close a file. I am putting stress on the words when I say read from and write to. You always read from a file and write to a file. Remember that. To enable us to achieve those functions or operations, we have input-output functions which file handling gives us. The first one is fopen. Now this fopen function takes two parameters, alright? So within the opening braces and the closing braces, you will have two parameters in double quotes separated by commas. I will illustrate the fopen to you, but for now you need to know that fopen is a function which I use to open a file, and it takes two parameters. The first parameter is the file name, and the second parameter is the mode in which I will be opening the file. It depends on whether you're opening it in write mode, read mode, or append mode. I am introducing you only to these modes at the moment. Whenever you open a file and whatever operations you have to do on it, you have done, say, there's one more function, that is fclose. This function is used to close the file. Fclose takes one parameter, and the parameter it takes is the file communication link, or in technical terms, it is called as the file pointer. I will explain to you what I mean by file pointer. But remember, fopen takes two parameters, fclose takes one parameter. Next is getc. Getc is a function which reads a character from a file. It takes only one parameter, that is the file link or the file pointer. For example, say that I have a file called as fe.txt. I refer to this fe.txt with a file link called as fe. Alright? In this fe, say I have one character which is stored as capital H. So if I want to pull out this capital H from my file fe.txt, alright, I will be placing the file pointer into this opening closing braces. Alright, so whatever name I use to refer to this file, that will be going into the opening and closing braces. So once I do that, I will get the character that I have placed in the file. Demonstration of this will also be given. Putc is one more function which helps us put a character in a file. Putc takes two parameters. The first parameter it takes is the character you want to put, and the second parameter it takes the file communication link you have to put the character in. For example, if you had four files and you have each communication link uniquely identifying each file, then you will have to be very specific as to which file you want to put the character in. For now, you may only understand that putc takes two parameters. The first parameter is the character, and the second parameter is the file in which you want to put the character. Both these parameters are separated by a comma. Next I have is getw. It is in the same analogy of getc. Getc is a character oriented function, whereas getw is an integer oriented function. It also takes only one parameter, that is the file pointer. Next we have is the putw. It works in similar lines like the putc, but again this is an integer oriented function. So putw is going to put an integer into the file, and you have to specify which file. So putw takes two parameters. The first parameter is the integer, and the second parameter is the file pointer. These two parameters are separated by comma. Now we have one more function, that is ftel. Ftel is a function which takes as a parameter the file pointer. It takes only one parameter, and by doing this, it's going to be telling us where exactly is the cursor present in a particular file. Rewind. Rewind takes one parameter, which is the file link or the file pointer. The function of rewind is to get the cursor back to the starting position of the file, wherever the cursor may be. Suppose, say, you have written a word into the file which says hello. The cursor at the moment right now is after the character O. So in case you do rewind now to this particular file, the cursor will come and sit at the begin of the capital H. FSeq is a function which I will illustrate and then explain to you towards my later programs. So let's come to how we define and open a file. So defining and opening a file. If we need to operate on files, we must specify the file name and the purpose. So when I say file name, it could be any name which you give to a file. In this case, for example, I take it as student is the name of my file. The .txt is the extension of the file. It could be .txt, it could be .pptx, it could be .doc, or it could be .docx. In this case, we'll have to specify what is the data structure. Since we are dealing with files, the data structure is the file itself. And you also have to specify the purpose for which you are opening the file. Maybe it could be for reading purpose or it is for writing purpose. So how do we declare a file? So you will open up your editor and put in your header file. Your header file is hash include stdio.h, and then you're going to have your void main, open curly braces, closing curly braces. Whenever you declare a file kind of a variable, you need to specifically put it as a capital F, capital I, capital L, and capital E. All file kind of variables are declared with the word capital F, capital I, capital L, and capital E. Then you place a space and put a pointer. The star which you see over here is a pointer, and any variable name or file communication link which you want to associate with the file that you will be using needs to be placed here next to the pointer, and then you terminate it with your semicolon. So over here, the point that we are using pointers is, by making use of a pointer, we are actually going to the content of that, to the memory space, and making changes over there. So whenever you close the file, you will see the contents that you have put exactly at that memory space. So you are actually intruding into that memory space and making changes in there. Therefore, the value is not going to get lost once you close. The value is always going to be starting at that memory space where you have declared the file. Therefore, the concept of a pointer. And since we are dealing with a file, it's a file pointer. Now this word that I used, FP, it is any valid identifier that I may choose. It can be FE, it can be FT, it can be anything, any valid identifier name. All right. So I hope I'm clear with declaring a file. This line over here focuses on declaring a file. So going on a little bit more, the star FP that you see, it declares a file variable FP as a pointer to the file. And this pointer contains all the information which serves as a communication link between the system, that is your computer system, and your C program. See, try to understand that you have a C program which you are running on an editor. Alright, on an ID. You're trying to open a file, could be a Word file or a text file, on your computer. Alright, there has to be some communication happening between your C program and the computer system. So this star pointer, that this is a star, that is a file pointer, is going to be serving as a communication link between your C program and your computer system. Getting my point? All right. So let's move ahead. So how do we open a file in a... Okay, we begin from where we stopped last time. So we shall now see how to open a file in a C program. The line indicated in pink, #includestdio.h, is your header file. Then we have your void main, open curly braces, close curly braces. This line, file*fp, indicates declaring a file pointer variable. How do we open a file? Now, if you recollect, in my beginning video, I had told you that we have a function available to open a file. The name of the function is fopen. So, fopen takes two parameters, name of the file and the mode in which you're going to be opening the file. Both these parameters are embedded within double quotes, separated by a comma. Now, this fp is going to be sitting over here. So we will say fp is equal to fopen, open curly braces, within the double quotes, name of the file, comma, the mode in which you are operating the file, whether it is read mode, write mode, or append mode. Care has to be taken that when you are opening the file for the first time, the mode has to be W. So, when you say file name, it could either be student.txt, trial.ppt, num.doc, anything like that. If you do not place a period and the extension of the file, it's still okay. In that case, the computer stores it as a default file type, which is called as a .dat. It's a data attribute file format. So, fopen, two parameters, file name and the mode. First time you're opening a file, it has to be in W mode. So here are the different modes of the file in which you may open a file. One is read mode, one is write mode, one is append mode. The first time you're opening a file, that is the first time you're bringing it into existence, you need to open it in the W mode. If a file which is not existing, you have used a R mode to it, it's going to throw you an error. If you don't wish to choose the W mode, you may still open the file in A mode, that is append mode. So if the file does not exist, it will still be created. However, which if you want to create the file for the first time, you open it in W mode, that is write mode. Once a file is created and written into and you close it and then you want to open the same file again, if you open it again in W mode, you lose all the contents of the file. So, if you want to open an existing file for reading purpose, you will have to open it in read mode. However, without losing any contents of the file, if you want to open an already existing file to add on more data to it towards the end, in that case, you will choose to open the file in append mode, that is A. So, please remember that if a file did not exist or does not exist, you cannot open it in read mode. It will throw you an error. If an already existing file is again opened in W mode, you will lose all its contents. To retain all its contents, to make any editing to it, like writing to it, you will have to open an already existing file in A mode. However, there is no harm if you open a file for the first time in A mode. If it does not exist, it is going to be created. So let's come to one small question. Here I say, declare two files, call them try1 and try2. I did not specify any extension. You may choose to put any or you may leave it blank. And I'm telling you to use the file pointers as ses1 for try1 and ses2 for try2. Open both of them. Open the first one, that is try1 in read mode, and open try2 in write mode. Now, since I've told you to open try1 in read mode, you have to assume that it had already been created in the past. Alright? And try2 is being created just now. So, how to solve that? So, if you see here, there are two files, try1 and try2. So, I have the two files Over here, the file pointers are try1, try2, sorry, and ses1 and ses2 are the files. So here I have the file ses1 and ses2, but before that I will have to declare the file variable. Now I have declared two file variables here, try1, comma, try2. Both are file pointers separated by a comma. So I hope this line is clear to everyone. A question may arise like, for example, if I have seven files to deal with, will I have seven different file pointers? Now, my point is, you may not have seven different file pointers. You may create one file pointer, operate it for one particular file, close that file, and then may reuse that file pointer for the second file, close that file, and repeat it for the seven different files. So you do not need n different file pointers for n different files. You may reuse a file pointer for n different files, provided you have closed one file and then used it for another file. You cannot have one file pointer talking to two files at the same point of time. That is not allowed. All right? Okay. However, which now, let's not get into that complexity. I have two file pointers here, try1 and try2. I'm using try1 as a communication link for sessional1, which is ses1.txt, which was created somewhere in the past, and using try2 for sessional2.txt. Now, please understand, this is what I mean by communication link. To talk to sessional1.txt at any point of time, I will be using the communication link try1, and to talk to sessional2.txt at any point of time, I will be talking with the help of try2. Now here there is no problem because each file is uniquely identified with the different communication links. So like you see over here, I say this communication link which is there here is equal to fopen, open curly braces, within double quotes, the name of the first file, comma, in read mode, since it's given to you in the question. Done with it, then come to try2 equal to fopen sessional2.txt write mode. The previous one was read mode, and close the curly braces. So this is going to be the solution to this particular question. Once you do this and you terminate and you run your C program and then you close it, if you go to your system and in the search as ses1.txt, you should see it because you had already created in the past. However, if that's not clear and we only take up this portion, that is try2 equal to fopen ses2.txt in write mode, there's a small problem here. This W should have been enclosed within double quotes. So there is an opening double quote and there is a closing double quote which is not there right now in this PPT. Please have a look at it and put it when you're coding it. So when you open a file for the first time, that is in case of a try2 sessional2.txt with the help of try2, and if you ignore this line of code when you are coding and you run the program, all right, when you go to your search window and search for sessional2.txt, you should see it. All right, okay. Let's see this with the help of a small code. Now here I have a C program, line number 1, hash include stdio.h, and I declare the file here. Then I use my fp equal to fopen, I say sunday.txt. Since I'm opening it for the first time, I place it in W. Alright? So here is a small piece of code which I have written to open a file. Let's compile it. Let's run it. So see, when you run it, right, this is what you're going to see. You don't know what is happening, all right? However, which if you come down here and say Sunday, you can see the file is created right now, 5th April 2020 to 14 p.m. and that's exactly today, right now, all right? So if I open the file, you have a notepad file created and there is nothing in it. You have just written a command to open a file. I'll close it manually, not through the program. So this is what your program would have shown you. You wouldn't know unless you manually go and check it. I'll close this. Now I'll put a small code here. Okay. In my code, I say if fp equal to null. Now if fp equal to null. Now you know that fp is a file pointer. If the file was not created, all right, because of some issue, then this would have been null. Not created, no data space in it, nothing there, so empty. So if the file was never created, it would have been a null pointer. So if fp at any point of time is equal to null, that means the file cannot be created or was not opened or cannot be opened. This can be any message you want to put. Now if fp is not null, means it's taken some value. Means somewhere in the memory it has got created. Your pointer has a value. So you can throw a message which says file opened. Now you come back here and you run. Now you see it's saying file opened. Alright, that means you don't have to stare at a black screen. You definitely know something has happened in the background and your file has been created. Alright, so this is with respect to file open and checking if the file has actually opened onto your system. I'll close this. Alright. Minimize this. So after seeing how to open a file, we will see how to close the file. So assume that we opened a file called as test.txt in write mode. And now we have just seen in the background whether it has opened, and it's opened. All right. We see that and verify it that it's opened. What is a command to close a file in a C program? The command to close a file in a C program is fclose. If you recollect, I told you that fclose takes one parameter and that parameter is this file communication link. So this one comes and sits in over here. So with that, we have finished all our communication with test.txt. Suppose you had another file, say test1.txt, which you wanted to open. You could have reused this pointer fp for test1.txt because you have made sure that it's closed over here. So that is exactly what I meant by having a pointer for two files, but make sure you close the first communication. So next, let's see how to use put c, get c in a file. Now if we try and recollect, get c and put c are character oriented functions for file handling. Put c takes two parameters and get c takes one parameter. The two parameters which put c takes is the character variable and the file in which you want to put it, whereas getC takes one parameter and that is the file pointer. Okay, let's come to the demo of the putC function, then we shall see the getC. So here I have a C program, alright, which starts off with the header file and the main function, and I have declared a file pointer, and the communication link I'm using is FP. Also, I've declared a character variable over here. The character variable is C, and I have assigned a value capital A to the character variable. I open a file. The name of the file is demo putc.txt. The file is being opened for the first time, therefore I open it in W mode. So I have a small piece of code because I don't want to just stare at a black screen. So I say if fp equal to null, printf file cannot be opened, else printf file open. And then I will say over here put c, the character variable c, in fp. I'll save this code, I'll compile it, and now I'm going to run it. The moment I run this code, I see an option which says file opened. So that's it. So I go here and I check for the file whether it exists. It does exist, and also the value that I put in the character variable C has gone and sat into the file, and this was the name of the file. So we verify that, and I will close this. I'll also close this black screen. Now I'll go ahead and change this to A, append mode. So now I'm opening it in append mode, and I come here and I say, instead of saying character C, the variable, I directly put a character, and the character is M. So let's see what happens, whether it works. So I save it, I compile it, and then I run it, and it says file opened. So that means there is no error. So I close this, I come back here, I come to the demo put.c dot demo putc, and I see that the initial A was already there, and now that I put M, that also has gone and sat in there. How is that possible? Now that was possible because I opened the file in A mode, that is append mode. So I had put capital A initially in it, okay, and now I went ahead and I put directly the character M in it, so because of which A was retained and then M got added to it. Now what if I change this back to W and make this D? Let's see what happens. Will we get A, M, D? And there is actually no use of this now because I'm directly using the character here. So let's check what happens. It says file open. So demo put C, and here you have a D. Is that okay? So I'll close this. All right. Now let's see. Now that we have put something into the file, how to get it out. Now we'll go ahead with that demo. The name of my file was demo put c dot txt. Now since it already existed, I will use it in the R mode. Now this is just assigned a value and kept, and what I should be getting out into my output is actually the D, which has just gone and set in at the moment. So let's see whether that works. So I'm using the function getC from fp, and since fp returns me back something, I will need a variable to hold it. So the variable to hold it is this character variable, and that is what I am printing out over here. So let's compile this and run it. So it says character from the file is D. That was exactly what was there in. So let us try one more thing over here. Instead of saying C, right, what I will do is I will say get C and put FP here. So I'll comment this and check whether it still works. Yes, it does work. So this was not required. This also was not required. So perfectly working fine. So this shows the demonstration of put C and get C. Now instead of having it separately like this, let's try it this way. So I have one file over here which says feit.txt. Alright, I open it for the first time in W mode. I say if fp equal to null, file cannot be open, else file open. Then I say at line number 18, put c comma fp. That means z should be going and sitting in this particular file. So assuming it's all fine, let's check whether all that gets done. So I'll save this, I'll compile this, and I'll run this. The name of the file was feit here. So we had put z, so z has gone in and sat there. Now I'll close this, I'll close this too. Now I'll comment this part because I need to open the same file and I say a rewind. Okay, let's not say this, and instead, since I've commented this W mode, I am opening my file in read mode. Okay, and now trying to read from that with the help of get C. Do you think this is going to work? Let's check. What we should get out on the screen is a Z. Says file open, that's it, and there is no Z coming out. That's because the pointer has gone and sat ahead of Z. So we need to get it back to the start of the file and now check whether we get Z. We still do not get Z. So how do I fix this piece of code? Now to fix this piece of code, go back and check whether the Z is actually there. So for that, if you see over here, the Z is there. So what you need to do is you have to go and have this over here rewind, okay, because you have not closed the file after putting that particular alphabet. So since you've not closed the file, your pointer has gone and sat beyond Z. So you need to go and rewind it so the pointer goes and sits at the start of the file, and then open the file in read mode. Then you can use this function getC and then have your character displayed. So let's check whether it works. You compile it and you run it. So what we had put was Z, so it says character from file is Z.
So it's working completely fine. So I'll close this now. Now we will see how to use the getCare function and then the putSee. For example, say that the user wants to insert a long statement on the console, and then he wants that particular statement to go and sit in a particular file. So I'm opening a new file now which says statement.txt, and since this is for the first time, I'm saying W mode. Now this is the same thing that I use to check whether file is open, close. So I'll just skip that right now. Alright, and now over here I say let's try entering a string to demonstrate getCare. Now I'm using a function called as getCare. Now it's here. So I say getCare. Now getCare is a console oriented function, that is whatever I type on the black screen will go into getCare, but character by character. For example, over here, that is on my console in the black screen, if I type hello, the first time getCare will pull up H. This H will go and sit in C because I need a variable to extract it. All right. Then I will have to dump that C wherever I want to dump it. The next time it will pull in E. The next time it will pull in L. The next time the second L. The next time O. And I assume that after typing hello, you say enter. So till I press enter, this getCare should go on absorbing these values. So that's how I demonstrate it over here. Every value absorbed by getCare needs to go and sit in a variable. So this is the character variable. So one by one, this value is going and sitting in statement.txt. So that is there over here. So let's try doing that. Save it, compile it, and now I run it. So it says file open, let's try entering a string to demonstrate getCare. So I say hello, I hope you are getting through this. Once I'm done with this, I say enter. So if you see, I had put an option here to see which is the character going in. So the first character A going in is H, the second one is E, third one is L. So that way all these characters that I have typed till here getting through this needs to go and sit into the file. So let us open the file and check. Name of the file, statement. It's here. So can you check that hello, I hope you are getting through this goes and sits in exactly over here. Alright? Okay. Now I close this since we have already verified it. Close this too. And with this we see the demonstration of getCare and putSee. Now what if we need to open that particular file and read back everything out onto the screen and paste it onto the screen? How to do that now? Now I come back to the same program, that is my statement.txt, and I change the file in read mode because whatever I had entered needs to be there. Alright, if I open it in W mode, it will go away. So here I say printf, let's try displaying the string to demonstrate putCare and getSee. Alright. So putCare is again a console oriented operation or function. It cannot be used to operate on a file. Alright, it can be used as a console oriented function. So the function that we have studied to pull up a character from the file is getSee. Alright, so we have to get
from a particular file. Which is that file? That file is FP. Now you go on getting till when? So every time you get, you place it in a character variable. You go on getting till this C is not going to be equal. This C is not going to be equal to the end of the file. Okay, so that goes this way. End of the file is written like this. So you have to do this entire step in repetition this way. So that's how I have written this function. Okay, so keep going on getting a character from the file with the help of getC. The file is fp till you don't encounter the end of the file, and as and when you get it, put it onto the screen. So if I run it, this is what I get. Hello, I hope you are getting through this. Now I will close this, open that file statement.txt and say, hi, I have just changed this. Okay, and then I say file, save, and close this, and then I run this. So I get the output as, hi, I have just changed this. Alright, so I could do it this way also. So along with this, I have demonstrated manually going into the file, changing and putting it onto the screen. You may also try, instead of saying put care, you may also try saying print f percent C and C. So with this you will get the same output. So I have not used a put care here, instead I have used a printf percent C. Alright, so I hope this is clear now, and with this I think I have demonstrated put C, get C, put care and get care. Now going back to my PPT, go back, have this here. Okay, similarly we have functions called, the last thing that we had seen was the operations of character oriented functions on files. Now we shall see another practice question. This practice question talks about creating a file called as data.txt. And over here, you're going to store 10 different numbers. These numbers will be accepted from the user. So how are you going to approach this? We had studied the functions getW and putW. The getW and putW are integer-oriented functions. GetW takes one parameter and putW takes two parameters. Put w takes the first parameter as whatever integer or the integer variable, and in the file that you want to put it is the second parameter, whereas get w takes only one parameter and that is going to be the file pointer. So both these are your integer oriented functions. Now here we have an assignment which says create a file data.txt to store 10 different numbers from the user. Also, open odd and even files to store odd and even numbers respectively after going through the data file. So to make sure that we implement the first case, that is create a file data.txt to store 10 different numbers, we open a file data.txt in W mode. We need to do that, but before we do that, we have to bring into existence three file pointers because we will be needing three files. So we will be needing one file pointer for data.txt, another file pointer for odd.txt,
and the third one for event.txt. So therefore we have our declaration of file variables written in red, file pointer *F1*, *F2*, *F3. F1 will be talking to data, F2 will be talking to odd, and F3 will be talking to even. I also have one more declaration over there which says int number and I. I is a variable for the counter. So because we are reading in 10 different numbers, and the number is the user defined number or the user input number at any point of time. So going on ahead, I open the file that I'll be using, that is data.txt, in write mode, and the communication link associated with data.txt is F1. Having done this, I make sure that I read 10 different numbers from the user, so that is indicated over here by saying scanf %d %number, and before that I am asking the user number. On seeing this, the user will enter any number of his choice, and that particular number goes and sits in F1, and this happens in a loop for 10 times. After doing this, I close the file. Now, in the question it said that you have to make sure that you access the data file, pull out a number one by one, and depending on whether it's odd or even, put it in an odd file or put it in an even file. So I close the file data.txt, and then I open all the three files, F1 in read mode, F2 which I have given for odd.txt in write mode because of the first time, and F3 for even.txt will be open for the first time, so in write mode. So this is how I'll be opening up the files. Data.txt will be opened up in reading mode. Now I have to pull up a number one by one from data.txt. So this I do with the help of this particular statement that you see here, while number equal to get w f1 not equal to end of file. I've already explained to you what I mean by eof, and get w is going to pull up numbers one by one from f1. So moving on ahead, I have to check if the number is even or odd. So that I do with the modulo operator v2. If it is even, I put it in F3. If it is odd, I put it in F2. So assuming the check is done and the numbers have been correctly placed, I need to display all the files. So I have to make sure I close them all, and then I open all of them in read mode. So here, opening all the files in read mode, because now I have to open each of them in reading mode to display the contents of each file. So here I'll display the contents of the original file and make sure all the numbers are displayed. If the closing here, I believe the braces are not closed rightly, make sure you close them if required. So here I've displayed the contents of the original file indexed by F1. Similarly, I'm trying to get the contents of the odd file. So what will be the pointer over here that I need to put? The pointer that you need to put over here is going to be for the odd file. Odd file is indexed with the file pointer F2. So you will be placing F2. Similarly for even file, you will be writing the same piece of code. However, in the while loop that you are writing, get w will take the file pointer as F3. So that is the explanation of operations of get w and put w. Now files are also used for handling inventory databases, which look something like this. So this is what I have entered on the console, and this is how it's gone and set onto the inventory.txt. So this is my notepad file wherein the data has been
put in this particular format. So here in this code, inventory.c, I'm trying to construct an inventory that is like a small database. This database consists of item name, item code, alright, and they both are strings, so I use character arrays. I'm also storing the quantity of each, so I use it as an integer data type for quantity. And I is going to be the counter variable because I need to ask the user how many items do you need to store. And num is actually how many items you need to store, and I is to iterate through the number of items the user wants to store. Every item will have a price, because of which I have this variable price, and the data type is float. The file pointer I'm using over here is in, alright, file star in. So in is equal to f open inventory.txt. I'm opening it for the first time, so therefore I've used the W mode. Now this is something similar we have seen in my previous video. I say that if in is equal to null, the file cannot be opened, else file is open. Then up till here, if everything is fine, the file should be open. So let's try and check whether the file is open. Can do that by commenting this portion of the code. So I compile this and then I run it. It says file open, but we need to go and check its inven.txt. So inven, it's here, and if you see, there is nothing in the file because I haven't put anything, so it is empty as of now. So I close this file. Now I come to the latter part of the code. The latter part of the code talks about putting something into the file. So over here at line number 20, let's try entering details in the inventory file. So it asks the user how many items, okay, and depending on how many items the user enters, suppose the user enters 5, this 5 goes and sits in num. So I'm using I as a counter variable to iterate 5 times. 5 times I'm entering from the user different values for item name, item code, quantity and price. Every time the user enters something, I have to read it in. So I'm making use of fscanf. Since I'm reading from the black screen, that is your console, I call that console as my standard in, standard input. So I use it as standard in. Then I place a comma, and then this is anyways written like how you write any normal scanf. The only difference is I put fscanf here, and here there's a standard in. However, you may choose to also write this as a normal scanf, like how you would write it this way. Okay. I just prefer to have uniformity in my code, because of which I am just avoiding this. So I say fscanf because I am doing file operation. I am reading whatever the user enters on the screen, and whatever I pull up from the screen, I want to put it into the file. To put it into a file, now it is important that you write fprintf. Which file are you putting in? You reference the file with a file pointer in. So you're putting whatever you have absorbed in the in file, put a comma, whatever you want to put, place all those format specifiers over here. So first thing you're putting is item name, second is you're putting item code, third is you're putting quantity, and then you're putting price. Alright, so let's try only implementing this portion and check whether whatever we are entering on the console goes and sits into the file. So I will comment the remaining portion of the code and check whether everything works fine. So I'll run this. Now it asks me how many items. So I say 5 items. Enter item name, item code, quantity and price. Item name I will say sharpener. Item code I will say A001. Quantity I will say 5. Price I will say 12.5. Second item I need to enter is I will say pen eraser. Item code I'll say B001. Quantity I will say 7. And price I will say 19.2. Third one I will say paintbrush. Okay. Then item code I will say C001. Then quantity I will say 3 and then price I will say 21.5. Fourth one I will say canvas paint, code is D001, quantity I will say 4 and price I will say 54.7. sorry, it didn't come to 7. Then the last one I will say file holder, item code is E001. I'll say quantity is 9, price is 90.2. so all these details that I have entered should have gone and sat into the file. So I will just check it out whether it's gone and sat into the file. So do you see, initially there wasn't anything. Now I have all the details that I entered onto the console coming and sitting onto the file. So when I'm reading from the console, that is my black screen, right, which you see over here, I call this as my console. So every time I'm reading something from this, I refer to this as a standard input, because the input may be coming from your keyboard or the input may be coming from your mouse. Whatever comes in here is read with the help of your fscanf. You may choose to use scanf, but when you're putting it into the file, you need to use a fprintf. Okay, so I close this. I also close this. Now I will comment this piece of code which does the writing part, because now I want to read, and if I again write, I will have to enter all that data again. So enter all the data means, in short, I'm losing the data. So I'll try reading out everything from that file. So I will run this, and then it says nothing. There's nothing coming out from the file. It says number of bytes consumed is 0 bytes. So I'll close this. I'll also come here and check. The file is open in read mode. Okay, so we see that the output says nothing. Only the headers come out. And this comes out because I have used one ftel statement later, which I will explain to you. So let us go and check why it isn't coming. If you notice over here, I have initialized num to 0, and in the commented part of my code I had accepted num from the user. However, we know that the value of num is 5,
because if I have to use it this way here, it will be a zero and nothing will happen. So I change it to 5, save this piece of code, and now check whether it runs. So now you see that I have all the data which was there in the inventory.txt coming out onto my console. Also, along with the data, there is one more small portion which comes, which says amount. This amount wasn't there when we had tried to put in stuff into the inventory.txt. Let me show you the inventory.txt. So the first one was sharpener A001, quantity 5, 12.5, and amount is 62.5. Now I'm making sure I print this out during display, and this amount is the price into the quantity, just to show you how maybe we can use something that is there in the inventory to probably print bills or receipts in future. Initially the number of bytes had shown as 0, now it shows as 142 bytes. Alright, so this was the inventory.txt and this is my console output. I'll just minimize this and minimize this also. So let's see how we did that. So this printf that we used here helped me in printing this portion out. Let's make this little small. This printf that was there here helped me in printing this portion out. Alright, I do it only once. Then I use a for loop and I do fscanf. You can, now you will have to use fscanf because you are reading from a file. Now since you're doing a file operation, you will have to do fscanf. You can't do a normal scanf because you're not doing console related operation, you're doing file related operation. So you will have to do fscanf, mention from which file you're reading in. Then you will have to give all the format specifiers, use the ampersands and capture them. To display it out onto the screen, I have used fprintf and then I have set std out. You may also choose to say normal printf and ignore this, like how we write a normal printf that way. But to again maintain uniformity, I have used fprintf. Where am I printing? I'm printing onto the standard out. So it's over here and all my format specifiers. Now here slash t slash t slash t is to give a tab space. This 0.2f, I have truncated my decimal values only up to 2 decimal places for price. And for the amount, I have used this rupees which is coming from here and I have again truncated this only up to 2 decimal places. Now to print this price, that's the last column, I have done price into quantity in my printing statement only. I have not used an extra variable. Now ft is integer data type kind of a variable. It says ftel in. In is the communication link to the file. This is going to give you the offset in bytes of where exactly your cursor is after entering all the data that you have entered at the moment. So as per that, it tells you that the total number of characters in your file, that is your invent.txt, is 142 bytes. Okay, and that's and that bytes is come out because I have printed it in that particular format. So I hope with this portion you have understood how to maintain an inventory database and print it out onto your console. You may also consider doing a small assignment wherein you're maintaining a phone book, that's a person's first name, a person's last name and his mobile number. Based on a search of a user's name entered by the user, you're supposed to display out his phone number. You may try to do that. Thank you for now. With this, I have done with files.